Hi, I am Shailendra Khandelwal. We have been dealing in home furnishings, upholsteries and blinds since past a half century now. Our company name is Srinath Furnishings and we have got several retail outlets by the name Verve. First of all, let us understand how fabrics are manufactured. We mainly categorize fabrics into two parts. The one is synthetic fabric and which are called man-made fabrics, and the other are natural fabrics. Natural fabrics are like linen, leather, cotton, wool, cotton blend, then you have vinyl, you have silks, all these are natural fabrics. Now, if we talk about synthetic fabrics, they are acetate, acrylic, nylon, olefin, then you have polyester, you have rayons. Now, let us understand how cotton is manufactured. The first step in cotton manufacturing is cotton growing. Then it goes for cotton ginning. Then the next step is cotton spinning, and post this step it goes for processing, which is called warping and sizing. Sizing of cotton is done to strengthen the yarn. Then we come to weaving part, and at this stage the fabric is ready in this form now, right? Now this is called gray fabric. Now this fabric is ready for dyeing, for printing, for embroidery, or for other processes. Now this fabric is ready for that. Now after this process, the final product that we receive is fabric, which is cotton fabric. In polyester, the process remains the same. The only part is it is man-made yarn. So directly it goes for warping. It does not require sizing as the yarn is already strengthened. So it does not require sizing. We straight away come to warping and the fabric is ready. The fabric is called gray, and then it is ready for printing, embroidery, other processes, dyeing or whatever. Then we receive the final product as polyester fabric. Now the important factors, what is the role of fabrics in architecture and constructions? We have to keep several aspects of fabrics in mind while we are dealing in constructions or we are in architecture. Now let us understand about technical textiles a bit. What are technical textiles? Once the fabric is already, it is at the gray stage, here several treatments are given to fabrics. They are fire retardant or fireproof, water repellent, oil and grease free. So these are several treatments that are given to fabrics at this stage, and they are called technical textiles. Nowadays we come across several projects, like if we talk about some 3-star or 5-star or 4-star properties, they require upholsteries and curtains which are technical fabrics. Like they should be fire retardant, they should be water repellent, they should be oil and grease free. So they are called technical textiles. Now let us talk about geotextiles. What are geotextiles? Fabrics that are used for heat proofing, that are used for sound proofing, that are used for light proofing are called geotextiles. Many a times we use fabrics for insulation, like in large banquet areas or say in home theaters, which is very trending nowadays. We use geotextiles as a part of interior and constructions, architecture and constructions. Fabrics are used for lighting purposes in industrial shades. Fabrics are also used in construction of roads and bridges to provide level for leveling purposes. They are used in construction of roads and bridges. So they are called geotextiles. A huge variety of different fabrics, both natural and synthetic or man-made, can be used for buildings. Some areas where fabrics are required to absorb or reabsorb humidity, like in areas, I would say coastal areas like Mumbai or Kolkata, these kind of fabrics are required. Then some fabrics are breathable. then you have nowadays furnishing industry in itself offers abundant possibilities in treating textiles in order to enhance the functionality of the material or to achieve special properties what are required by the project. But we need to take into account the minimum order size. That is a key that we need to understand. We need to take into account a minimum order size, a MOQ, that is also subjective, varies from fabric to fabric, and also it varies from corresponding treatment to treatment. Now let us understand what interior and outdoor fabrics are. Apart from the basic objective to provide colors, to provide flavor, to provide beautification to a space, usage of fabrics differ on the basis of whether they are used in interior or exteriors. Now, outdoor fabrics have different properties. Outdoor fabrics differ from indoor fabrics in that they are made more durable and they undergo a chemical treatment process during manufacturing that ensures they will resist stains and mildew. Outdoor fabrics are woven fibers that differ in strength and durability. They are used in areas like the upholstery that is done in boats, for awnings and canopies, for waterproofing decking, for vinyl printing, and several other uses are there of exterior fabrics. Now let us understand technically what exterior fabrics are, how are they made. The first thing is they are solution dyed acrylics. Solution dyed acrylics are fabrics that are dyed before the yarn is created. With solution dyed acrylics, a liquid acrylic solution is mixed with the dye, and that is formed into a fiber, so it already has color before it is spun into a yarn. This process makes its color fast and water resistant. Solution dyed acrylics are soft and breathable like canvas and are commonly used in awnings and patio umbrellas. But a softer or more porous version is also used for outdoor pillows and cushions. Now, whenever you are entering into any furnishing store, how will you ascertain that whether the fabric is for outdoor or indoor purpose? So on the back of every fabric, like this, there is a folder available in a furnishing store, and you go there and suppose you see this fabric, right? Now, how will you come to know that this is an outdoor fabric or this is an indoor fabric? An outdoor fabric, it is a typical property where it will be written like solution dyed acrylic, or there are various kind of fabrics which are to be used in outdoor purposes only. So the properties are always going to be mentioned there. Now you can make out from the composition of the fabric whether it can be used for outdoor purpose or not. Then there are several other types of acrylic coated polyesters. Acrylic is used as a base for many outdoor fabrics because of its durability and resistance to wrinkling, fading, and mildew growth. So other widely used outdoor fabrics are vinyl coated synthetic fiber mesh. Then you have olefin. Olefin is very widely used in outdoor fabrics. You have canvas. Now, outdoor fabrics are widely used in restaurants, cafes, or in porch in domestic areas which use outdoor fabrics, where there is a wide use of outdoor fabric is there. Now let us talk about indoor fabrics. There is a huge variety available on furnishing stores of indoor fabrics. Indoor fabrics, there can be several fabrics which can be used for indoor purposes. Rather, I would say a huge variety of indoor fabric is available everywhere across. If we talk about indoor fabrics, we can categorize broadly into two parts, natural fabrics and synthetic fabrics. Natural fabrics are linens. These kind of fabrics, they are best suited for living rooms, formal living rooms or adult areas, because it soils and wrinkles easily and it won't withstand heavy water. Here we need to take into account that it won't withstand heavy water. So however, linen does resist pilling and fading. So soiled linen upholstery must be professionally cleaned to avoid shrinkages. Then there is another natural fabric, which is leather. This fabric is tough material and can be gently vacuumed, damp wiped as needed, and cleaned with leather conditioner or saddle soap. Then I had explained how cotton is manufactured, which is a natural fabric. This natural fabric provides good resistance to wear, fading and pilling. It is less resistant to soil wrinkling and fire. Durability and use depend on the weave and finish. Like damask weaves are formal, canvas is more casual and more durable. So, but they are form of cotton fabrics only. There is another natural fabric, which is wool. Many a times we come across a question about pilling and fading. So here I can address that question. Wool is sturdy and durable. Wool and blends offer good resistance. Wool and wool blends offer good resistance to pilling, fading, wrinkling and soil. Generally, wool is blended with a synthetic fiber to make it easier to clean and to reduce the possibility of felting the fibers, causing them to bond together until they resemble felt. Blends can be spot cleaned when necessary. We have cotton blends. Depending on the weave, cotton blends can be sturdy, family-friendly fabrics. Here, I would recommend a stain-resistant finish should be applied for everyday use. Then you have vinyls. Vinyl fabrics are easy care and less expensive than leather. Vinyls are ideal for busy family living areas and dining rooms. Durability depends on quality totally. Then you have a very delicate fabric, which is called silk. Silk is another natural fabric which is suitable for adult areas such as formal living rooms. It must be professionally cleaned if soiled. Now let us talk about synthetic fabrics, or typically termed as man-made fabrics. I would talk about acetate. Developed as imitation silk, acetate can withstand mildew, pilling and shrinking. However, it offers only fair resistance to soil and tends to wear, wrinkle and fade in the sun. It's not a good choice for furniture that will get tough everyday use. Then you have acrylic. Acrylic fabrics are this synthetic fabric was developed as imitation wool. It resists wear, wrinkling, soiling and fading. Low quality acrylic may peel excessively in areas that receive high degrees of abrasion. High quality acrylics are manufactured to peel significantly less. You have nylon. Nylon is another synthetic fabric. It is rarely used alone. It is kabhi bhi nylon hum matlab pure nylon nahi use karte. Usko ab hamesha hum blend karenge. Nylon is usually blended with other fibers to make it one of the strongest upholstery fabrics. Nylon is very resilient. In a blend, it helps eliminate the crushing of napped fabrics such as velvet. It doesn't readily soil or wrinkle, but it does tend to fade and pill. Then you have olefin. I would say this is the good choice for furniture that will receive heavy water. It has no pronounced weaknesses as such. Now, you have polyesters. Rarely used alone in upholstery, polyester is blended with other fibers to add wrinkle resistance, eliminate crushing of napped fabrics and reduce fading. We have to always keep in mind that polyester blended with wool can aggravate pilling problems. So we should always be careful about it. Now you have rayon. Developed as an imitation silk, linen and cotton, rayon is always durable. However, it wrinkles. Recent developments and researches and developments have made high quality rayon very practical now. Now, being on furnishing stores, many a times we encounter certain questions what kind of fabric should we take for our curtains and what kind of fabric should we take for upholsteries, for our chairs, for our loose furniture. So this is a commonly asked question. Now there are several aspects that we should keep in mind while we are choosing our curtains. The first thing that we should keep in mind is, curtains are an essential part of our home decor. It defines a room. So fabric influence the look and life of your curtain. There is a wide variety of fabric to choose from, which is available across all furnishing stores. So apart from your personal choice and taste, there are some tips to choose the right fabric for your curtains. The first thing is durability. If you are not a regular changer of fabrics, you should always keep durability in mind. The second thing is ease to maintain. Many fabrics like silk and velvets require dry cleaning. Some fabrics are easy to wash like synthetic fabrics. So we need to keep in mind how comfortable are we with maintenance of the fabric. Now, the third thing that we should always keep in mind is size and style. The size and style of curtains influence the choice of fabrics. Lightweight fabrics are better for tap-top style of curtain. However, heavy fabrics curtains are required for large doors and windows which are airy so that the curtains do not keep flying. Then we should always keep in mind affordability, yes, of course. Always choose the fabric keeping in mind your budget. The amount of fabric needed also vary with curtains. जैसे आपका कोई एरिया है जहाँ पर 10 मीटर कर्टेन लगना है तो देयर यू माइट चूज अ कर्टेन फैब्रिक ऑफ से रेंजिंग फ्रॉम 1500 रुपीज और मे बी 2000 रुपीज अ मीटर बट देयर इज अ प्लेस वेयर यू नीड टू इंस्टॉल लाइक 100 मीटर्स ऑफ फैब्रिक सो हियर प्रोबेबली एवरीबडी वुड कंसिडर दैट ओके लेट अस रेस्ट्रिक्ट आर बजट हियर एंड लेट अस यूज अ फैब्रिक कीपिंग आर बजट इन माइंड ओके सो देन The next thing is functionality of the fabric. You cannot use some fabric for every room. Different fabric serves different purposes or different functions. For casual rooms, you can use bright and delicate fabrics as they are used just for decoration. However, in bedroom, you need fabric neither very light nor very dark or dreary. Then you also need to cover the aspect of natural lighting. This is a very important thing that you need to consider. Choose the fabric of curtain on the basis of natural lighting in that area. Some fabrics fade or get damaged with regular exposure to sun, so avoid such fabrics in sunny areas. Now, fabrics have a very important role in temperature moderation. Some fabrics help in moderating the temperature of the room and keeping the heat in. Like we talk about suedes, we talk about tweeds, we talk about velvets. Such fabrics, they keep the cold out. But if you want the room to be cool, go for linens and cottons. Like in areas when we talk about northern parts of India, maybe Rajasthan, western parts of India, I'm sorry, Rajasthan or Delhi or regions where there is a lot of, heat is there. So we need to put, we should use more and more of cottons and linens in these areas to moderate the temperature. Now, weave also makes a lot of difference. Loosely woven fabrics lets the light pass through it. Similarly, a higher thread count means less light will pass through. If you want the room to be dark, you go for tightly woven fabrics. However, if you want the room to be light or sunny, choose loosely woven fabrics. Now, here I have mentioned a thread count. जब भी आप किसी फर्निशिंग स्टोर पे जाते हैं तो वहाँ पर आपको जो सेल्समैन होते हैं बोलते हैं मैडम ये बेडशीट आप देखिए एंड दिस हैज़ गॉट 300 थ्रेड काउंट और 400 थ्रेड काउंट और 250 थ्रेड काउंट तो वो थ्रेड काउंट क्या होता है थ्रेड काउंट इज नंबर ऑफ थ्रेड्स पर स्क्वायर इंच ऑफ फैब्रिक नंबर ऑफ थ्रेड्स पर स्क्वायर इंच ऑफ फैब्रिक्स दैट इज कॉल्ड थ्रेड काउंट राइट सो अब जब भी आप कभी फर्निशिंग स्टोर पर जाएं तो आप देखें कि थ्रेड काउंट फैब्रिक का कितना है because that will make a lot of difference. Now, then we always consider look. Different fabrics give different looks to the room. If you want the glossy and elegant look, you go for real silk and false silk. But if you want to give simple and sophisticated look, you go for linen or velvet. So the important aspect that we also keep in mind is pattern or color, pattern and color of fabric. Fabric comes in different patterns and colors. Choose fabric on the basis of pattern and color schemes of your room. Your curtain fabric should go with furnishing of the room. This is a very important aspect. आपकी जो color scheme होती है, that should go well with the color scheme of the room. Now, let us talk about whenever we are going to buy upholstery for our furniture. So, what all factors that we should consider? Now, the most important thing is shape of furniture. Now, take the shape of the furniture into consideration when you are choosing fabrics. Say, if you are upholstering a curvaceous piece of furniture, always stick to solid patterns, solid color patterns, I would say, or textures with not much distinctive direction because they may not upholster well. The thing is, if there is a lot of pattern on the fabric, if there is a lot of texture on the fabric, and the fabric, the furniture has turns and the furniture is curvaceous, so it is going to be difficult for the upholsterer to match the designs. So that is the reason you should always consider the shape of the furniture in mind while you are choosing upholstery for it. Then size makes a difference. Take the size of the furniture into consideration. Like a big sofa in a rich solid color or classical neutral will not bore you over a period of time. So you should always take size in consideration whenever you are choosing upholstery for your furniture. The third thing that you should keep in mind is while choosing upholstery, that furnishing of the room should go well hand in hand with it. Other furnishing of the room should go well hand in hand with it. Always make sure the colors, patterns and textures work well together. Now एक और प्रॉब्लम जो आजकल फेस करते हैं फर्निशिंग्स के लिए कि जब भी हम किसी फर्निशिंग स्टोर पर जाते हैं तो दे शो अस द फोल्डर राइट बट दैट इज द नीड ऑफ द आर यू कैन नॉट क्वेश्चन इट बिकॉज इट इज प्रैक्टिकली इम्पॉसिबल फॉर एनी फर्निशिंग स्टोर टू मेंटेन दैट लेवल ऑफ इन्वेंट्री और दैट लेवल ऑफ स्टॉक सो दैट ही कैन शो यू अ लार्जर पीस But if possible, if you cannot visualize the pattern, if you cannot visualize the exact how will this fabric will turn out onto the furniture, you can ask for a bigger piece. Probably a furnishing store will provide you a bigger piece, but if it is not, then you have to visualize it. Always consider, there is one thing that we should keep in mind is children and pets. They are to be kept in mind if you are selecting upholstery for any particular place. Choose accordingly because avoid fabrics which are not stain resistant in this particular case always avoid fabrics which are not stain resistant then your mind should be led by your practical needs that is very important I would say now the choosing upholstery is not that we have very recently started this is a story which had began in the 17th 18th and 19th centuries Over the years, a wide variety of materials have been used, from hay to horse hair to wool. And it makes a lot of difference what all material that has been used inside your furniture. It makes a lot of difference. So modern upholstered items are metal spring and foam for greater durability. Though the inner material is not visible, they make a big difference in whether the piece is comfortable or not. Therefore, the inner material should be decided diligently. Check the there is one important aspect that you should always cover while choosing upholstery is the rubs and martindale. There is a very important aspect that you need to cover while you are going to purchase upholstery for your client or for yourself. Whenever you are going to some furnishing place, he shows you the folder like this, and on the back of it, as I had mentioned earlier also about those outdoor fabrics, there is a property which is called martindale or rubs. It is always there. It is 10,000, 15,000 or 20,000 or 22,000, but it is always written. So anything above 10,000 is reasonably well enough for any kind of upholstery or furniture. But if the use is say very rough, then you should consider say above any martindale or rub above 20,000. That is ideal. There are several advantages of using fabrics for buildings, just to name a few, like for lighting purposes. There can be multiple advantages to fabric structures over traditional buildings in certain scenarios. In some cases, no lighting is required as the fabric used is generally translucent, which makes it an energy efficient solution. Another advantage of using fabric is mobility. We can move them either on wheels or relocate them totally. So that is also a cost-saving tool for if we use fabric for construction purposes. Then you have savings. They cost almost about half of what a traditional structure used to cost. Now, what are the different properties of fabrics? When discussing fabric properties for use on a structure, there are several terms that are commonly used. Like tensile strength of fabric. Tensile strength is a basic indicator of relative strength. It is fundamental for architectural fabrics that function primarily is tension. Tear strength is important in that if a fabric ruptures in place, it generally will do so by tearing. This can occur when a local stress concentration or local damage results in the failure of one yarn, which thereby increases the stress on remaining yarns. Now, when we discuss about fabric properties, the main thing that we need to consider is tensile strength. Tensile strength is a basic indicator of relative strength. It is fundamental for architectural fabrics that function primarily as tension. Tear strength is important in that if a fabric ruptures in place, it generally will do so by tearing. This can occur when a local stress concentration or local damage results in the failure of one yarn, which thereby increases the stress on remaining yarns. So that we always need to consider while considering the properties of fabric. Nowadays, we come across some basic problems when we see that client wants some specific design or style in curtains or blinds or other soft treatment over windows. Now, to address it, I would say that leave a space of around 7 or 8 inches at inception level only, I mean at drawings level only, near to the window for curtains or blinds or whatever window treatment we want to give to that place. Now, that will surely help a lot to design and think about it when the actual stage comes and the site is about to be handed over now. Many a times nowadays we come across, now UPVC windows are in trend, right? Now when we open the door of UPVC window from inside, it obstructs the curtains. Now let's say there is a wall size of 15 feet by 15 feet and the window size is 10 feet by 10 feet. Now at drawings level, if we leave sufficient space for curtain gathering, then that problem gets resolved. Say here and here. In drawings only, if we leave a space after gathering of curtains, this space will get acquired. So I think that is a solution to the problem ki jab hum UPVC window ka door open karenge to curtains ko obstruct karega. Of lately we have seen a major change in architectural designs nowadays. Big size windows from 10 feet to 10 feet or say from 20 feet to 20 feet or even more we come across. Now curtain heights at these places should be at least 3 to 4 inches from the ground level. If this is the ground level, then the curtain should be like 3 to 4 inches from the ground level, because this is the property of fabric that it stretches with time. Say in a couple of months or in a 3 or 4 months time, the curtain will stretch and it will drop down till a couple of inches from the ground level. So this is going to be there. So we should instruct the stitching unit only that you should keep the height of the curtain if the curtains are very long in height. Say 18 feet curtains are there or 20 feet curtains are there, sheer curtains are there, main curtains are there. We should always keep them at 3 to 4 inches from the ground level, because with time they will stretch and they will come down to this level. Now there is one more thing that I would like to put light on. The thing is, many a times we come across near to the window, the space for channels or tracks on which the curtains are to be hanged is false sealed. Now the thing is, if there is a false ceiling, then you cannot drill in the false ceiling, right? Before paint only, we should instruct the carpenter only to just put a board near to the, underneath the ceiling. So drilling purpose gets served. So that is one problem that we have come across many a time. Nowadays, you have a wide variety of fabrics available across all furnishing stores. Price, I would say they are ranging from say 50, 60 rupees a meter till 22,000 or 25,000 rupees per meter. That is the, huge range available across everywhere now. Various kind of blinds are roller blinds, triple shade blinds, you have zebra blinds, you have honeycomb blinds. They are also termed as energy saving blinds because they are structured in the form of honey cell. Jab madhumakhi ka chhatta dekhte hain to usme honey cell bane hue hote hain. It is structured that way only, so that is the reason it deflects light to a certain level that it reduces your electricity bill. That is the use of honeycomb blinds. Then you have heated blinds, you have panel blinds, you have Romex blinds, you have Roman blinds, and there are several other forms of blinds which are available in the market. This fabric is in grey form. We have dyed it and we have further treated it with water repellent treatment. Now I am going to pour water over it. Now water will keep moving over it. It will not soak. This is a water repellent treatment. The same way, fire retardant treatment is done. And the same way, oil and grease free treatments are done.